My dear children, I'm Miss Rishika. Today in this video, I'm going to teach you the bank reconciliation statement for grade 8. First, we'll see what is a bank statement. Bank statement is issued by the bank to the business, including all the transactions which they have done throughout the month. So normally, the bank statement will be issued at the end of each month. So it shows the amounts or the transactions which you have done throughout the month. Then we'll see what is the bank reconciliation statement. Here it says bank reconciliation statement means which makes the comparing of cash book. Okay, so bank reconciliation statement is a statement which you prepare temporary to just to compare the cash book balance with the bank statement balance. And this will be prepared if the cash book closing balance and the bank statement balance differed with each other. And you can use two methods to make the bank reconciliation statement. The first method is without updating the cash book, and the second method is after updating the cash book. Okay, so bank reconciliation statement is a temporary statement where you record the transaction which makes the difference between the two balances. So only this will be prepared if the cash book balance and the bank statement balance differed with each other at the end of the month. Now we'll see what are the reasons for these difference. Okay, when you get the bank statement at the end of the month, if you find your cash book balance and the bank statement balance differs with each other, okay. For an example, your cash book balance showed 10,000 and the bank statement balance shows only 9,500. So there is a 500 difference. Now we'll see why there is a difference. The first reason is unpresented checks. Unpresented checks means the checks that you have given to a person or the checks that has been issued by the business but has not been cleared through the banking. Now for an example, assume you have issued a check for a person called Silva, but until the month end, we'll assume the month of May, at the end of the May even, that Pereira has not been cleared the bank check from the bank. So these checks are called unpresented checks. So unpresented checks means the business has already issued the checks, but the person who received has not transferred into cash. The second reason is the bank lodgment that not yet entered in the bank statement. For an example, assume that you have already deposited a check which you have received from a person, but it takes time for a check to realize by the bank. For an example, if you deposit a check today, okay, it takes 5 to 6 days to realize it to the bank. So if you have already deposited but if it not recorded in the bank statement, we call these bank lodgment or unrealized checks. So all these two reasons will be find out. You will be able to find when you compare the cash book, and these two reasons will be in the cash book. When we are doing an example, I'll show you which side it will be occurred. And there are some other reasons which you will be able to find out in the bank statement. These reasons you will be able to find out when you compare the bank statement. The first reason is direct debt. It says a direct debt is when a business gives permission for an organization or for a person to collect the amount owing by the business directly from the bank account. For an example, if we are owing an amount of money to a person called Silva, and if we have given the permission to Silva to directly take it from the bank, then it is called direct debts. The next one is standing order. Standing order means if the business has already given the permission to the bank to continuously pay an amount monthly wise or annually, continuously pay an amount of money to a specific expense. For an example, it can be your insurance, it can be your bank loan installment, like those. Standing orders are giving permission to the bank to do some expenses on behalf of the business. So all these reasons will be occurred in the bank statement. Now we'll see another reason. This reason is called bank charges. Bank charges means when you have started to do transactions from the bank account, we have to open a current account. So when you open a current account using your business's name, they are giving you different facilities. They allow you to use their checkbooks, they allow you to do transactions through the bank account. So because they are giving these services, they are applying a charge or a fee during the month. So bank charges mean the cost charged by the bank because they are giving some services to the business. Then the interest. Interest can be interest received or interest paid. Interest received means directly you can receive some amount of interest on behalf of your fixed deposit. Or interest can be paid for your overdraft, bank overdraft. Bank overdraft means a temporary bank loan which has been given by the bank for the business. So interest also a difference, a reason for the difference between the cash book balance and the bank statement. So it can be two interest that you have received and interest that you have paid. Then the last other reason is the bank transfer. Bank transfer means an amount of money which a debtor or a person who owes you has directly debited to your bank account without informing. For an example, a person called Jacob has to pay 10,000. But without informing the business, if he deposited that 10,000 directly to the business current account, that is assumed as bank transfer. Okay, so these are the other reasons, and these reasons can be found in the bank statement. Now we'll look at a worked example. These are the questions you will be getting. This is a column type question, otherwise you might get an essay type question as well. So I'm using here a column type question. Here they have given an extracted cash book and a bank statement of a business. Okay, now first what you have to do, you have to compare the cash book balance with the bank statement balance. If you look at this, you will be able to see this is the month of December. Okay, the last balance, the closing balance or the opening balance for the next month is 560, but here it shows 405. That means the cash book balance differs from the bank statement balance. And here, children, you have to assume to the business, this bank account we are assuming as an asset. So we are treating them as an asset. But to the bank, we are liabilities because we have deposited our cash. So whenever we are asking from the bank has to return. So they are liable to us. So the bank is treating us, the business, as a liability. So you know, you have already learned when liability increases, it's credit. When the liability decreases, it debit. But assets increases, it will be debit. When asset decreases, it will be credited. So keep that in your mind. Cash book, the bank account will be assuming as an asset. But the bank statement, they are assuming our account as a liability. Now we are comparing. Now we found that the balances are different. Okay, cash book balance shows a 560 pounds, but the bank statement shows 405 credit balance. Now we'll see why there is a difference. What you have to do is, you have to compare the cash book debit column or debit side with the credit column, okay? Because Cash is an asset. When it increases, it will be debited. But bank, they are treating as a liability. So whenever we deposit, they credit, because liability increases will be credited. And you have to compare the credit side with the debit column. Okay? Because assets decrease will be credited, but liability decrease will be debited. So the first step is you have to compare the cash book debit side with the credit column and the credit side with the debit column. Now we'll compare first the debit side with the credit column. You'll be able to see the opening balance, they are equal with each other. Then this day J. Catton 60, here it's already recorded. But you'll be able to see that this 220 has not been recorded in the credit side. So you can circle it and make it as the reason. So we found out the first reason which makes the difference between the cash book and the bank statement. Now, not only that, after you compare the debit side with the credit side, make sure you compare the credit side with the debit side as well. Now here, when you compare the credit side with the debit side, you'll be able to see there is a different amount which has not been recorded in the cash book. So you can circle it and keep. Now we are going to compare the credit side with the debit side. Credit side 105 is already recorded. Then you'll be able to see this 15 has not been recorded in the debit column. So you can circle it. Now after that, after you compare the credit side with the debit column, you have to compare the credit side with the debit column. So you have to compare four times to find the reasons. So when you compare the credit side with the debit column, you will be able to see this difference, 20, which I have highlighted using the yellow color. So when we compare the first step, we compare the cash book balance with the bank statement and found how many reasons? 1, 2, 3, 4 reasons. Now I'm going to explain you what are these reasons. Already altogether we learned there can be unpresented, there can be bank lodgement, standing orders, direct debt, then bank charges, interest, and also bank transfers. Now we'll see what type of reasons these are. Now look at the debit side. You'll be able to see a person named called Qureshi has given a check to us. So we, as soon as we receive the check, we will record them in the cash book bank column. But it has not been recorded in the bank statement. That means this is called the bank lodgement or unrealized checks. The checks which has been deposited, but it takes time. So when you receive the bank's statement for the month of December, it has not realized. So this is called the bank lodgement that not entered. Bank lodgement. So always remember, if you get a circled number on the cash book debit side, definitely it's a bank lodgement. Now we'll see the credit side. Credit side, M. Haddad. Okay, we have issued a person, a check for a person called M. Haddad, but he has not presented into the bank. So we called it, we have learned already, we have to call it the unpresented check. Check that has been issued but not presented to the bank, we called unpresented checks. So we name the reasons which we found out when we are comparing. We found these reasons. Always remember, bank lodgement and unpresented checks will be there in the cash book. So debit one will be bank lodgement, the credit one will be unpresented check. Now we look at the bank statement. Bank statement, we have 70. So already it has mentioned it's the bank transfer. We call it bank zero credit, BGC. That means L safe, who has to pay us 70 without informing he has deposited to our business account. Now you will be able to see a 20 which is on the debit side. This is right in front of that 20, they have recorded, it's the bank charge. So other reasons we have learned: standing order, direct debt, bank charges, interest, bank transfers. All these five reasons will be able to find out in the bank statement. Okay, so we finished the first step. What did we do? We compared the debit side with the credit column, credit side with the debit column, and find out the reasons and circle them, and we named all those things. So we have here why it differs because of these four reasons. Now we'll see the first method. I told you there are two methods that you can make the bank reconciliation statement. The first method is without updating the cash bill. That means whatever the reasons that you have found, you are recording all of them in the bank reconciliation statement and make it. Now we'll find the first one. Now already, if you can remember in the earlier one, we found out four reasons. One was unpresented checks, which has a value of 50, and there was a bank lodgement for 220, and there was a bank zero credit, that means a bank transfer for 70, and there was a £20 for bank charges. So these were the reasons that we found out when we compared the bank book with the cash book with the bank statement. Now using these reasons, now we are going to do without update in the cash book. That means all these four reasons should be included when we are making the bank reconciliation statement. The first method, making without updating cash book even, there are two methods where you start with the cash book balance and ends with the bank statement balance. Now we'll see how it can be done. Now you can remember the cash book balance shows you at the end the closing balance was 560. So you have to make sure that you take the closing balance, not 400, but the closing balance which is there in the cash book. So it gives you 560. Now we'll see the first reason how it's done. So some reason should be added and some reason should be subtracted. Now here it says the unpresented check should be added. Now I'll show you why it should be added. For an example, assume your business at the very beginning of the month of December, your business and bank has 1,000 balance. So both of the balances were equal. Okay? Unpresented means you have issued the check but not presented. So assume you have given or you have issued a £200 check to a person. So what you will do, as soon as you issued the check, you deduct this 200. So your balance become 800. So here you'll be able to see after you issue the check, your balance goes down, but still the bank shows 1,000 balance. Now here what you have to do, you have to make sure, you cannot go and ask bank to correct them. What you have to do, you have to correct yourself. Here you have to correct yourself. So to correct this one, what you have to do, to equal the 800 into the bank amount 1,000, this 200 which you subtracted should be added. So that's why we add the unpresented checks. So unpresented checks we deduct from the cash book balance, but the bank did not deduct it. So what we have to do, to equal our bank account balance to the bank statement, the one which we deduct, we have to add it, because we cannot ask bank to correct, we have to correct ourselves. So that's why, children, here you have started with the cash book balance. That's why we add the unpresented checks. Now we'll see the second one, the bank lodgement. You will be able to see this bank lodgement has been less from the bank balance of the cash book. Now I'll show you why is it. Now we'll take the business, same one, the business and the bank. Business, earlier 1,000 was there, then the bank also shows 1,000. Bank lodgement, I have already explained, bank lodgement means a check that you have received and you deposited immediately. As soon as you receive, you are depositing that. So what happens? When you deposit the £200, you increase your value and your value becomes 1,200. So earlier, at the very beginning of the month, your balance and the business balance was same. But as soon as you deposited a check called 200, your balance increased to 1,200. Still, that check has not been realized by the bank. That means still the business bank account shows 1,000. But our balance shows 1,200. So what you have to do? You have to correct yourself. So to equal our balance to the bank balance, what you have to do? The added 200 should be subtracted. So that's why we lost the bank lodgement that not entered in the cash book from the balance of the cash book. Okay, so bank lodgement, increase your balance. Okay, so your balance will be larger than the bank balance. So to make it equal, you have to subtract it. Now we'll see BGC. BGC means bank transfers. That means direct transfer which a person has done without informing the business. Now you will be able to see this bank zero credit or bank transfer has been added. Now I'll explain you why it has been added. Bank transfer means, assume the same one, business has a 2000 balance and the bank has same balance at the very beginning. Now a person called Silva comes and deposit a check or cash in our bank account. Now the bank balance increase in the bank statement balance increases to 3000, but still we did not know. Until we receive the bank statement, we do not know that the person called Silva has directly debited. So still our business balance shows 2000. So as I said, we have to correct ourselves. So 2000, to equal it to the bank 3000, what we have to do? This 1000 which they have added, we have to add as well. Okay, because we have to correct ourselves. So to equal the business 2000, here bank statement is greater than the business value. So this 1000 should be added. Then our bank balance will be equal to the bank statement balance. So that's why the bank transfer will be added to the cash book balance. Now the last reason is bank charges. Bank charges means the checkbooks for the facilities, for the services that they give us, they are charging an amount from us. So what happens? We'll take another example. Business value has 1000 and the bank has same value 1000. Now at the end of the month, because they are giving us different services and facilities, they have deducted 100 from our bank account. Okay, so until we get the bank statement, we do not know that they have deducted this £100. So what has happened? The bank statement balance decreases to 9,900. So our balance still is 1,000 and their balance shows 900. So our balance is greater than the bank statement balance. So we have to correct ourselves. So what we have to do? This 100 which the bank has deducted, we have to deduct as well. Then when we deduct, it will be equal to the bank statement balance. So that's why the bank charges will be less from the cash book balance. So these unpresented checks, bank transfers, they make the cash book balance less than the bank statement balance. That's why we add them. Bank charges and bank lodgement not yet entered in the cash book, they make our balance greater than the bank statement balance. So that's why we lost them from the cash book. So finally, you started with the cash book balance and you ends with the bank statement balance. So you can check whether this is correct. How? Here, 405. Okay, so when you do the bank reconciliation statement, even you got 405 as your balance as per bank statement. Okay, so this is the first method where you started with the cash book balance and you end with the bank statement balance. So here we are doing without updating the cash book. Now we'll see without updating the cash book, what is the second method? Earlier we started with the cash book balance, but in the second method, we are starting with the bank statement and we are ending with the cash book balance. Now what you have to do, the ones which you have added, you have to subtract here. The ones which you added, subtracted earlier method, you have to add here. That means the first method, whatever you did, the opposite you have to do when you are starting with the bank statement balance and when you ends with the cash book balance. So here you have started with the 405 and you got the cash book balance. You can remember in the cash book it shows the closing balance 560. So there are two methods. Either you can start with the cash book balance and end with the cash bank statement balance, or you can start with the bank statement balance and you can end with the cash book balance. Now we'll see the same example I have taken, but here we are doing the bank reconciliation statement after updating the cash book. That means before you start the bank reconciliation statement, you have to update the cash book. Now here you have to make sure that you take the closing balance of the cash book. Closing balance, if you can remember, it was 560. Then we found four errors. There were unpresented checks of £15. £15, and there were bank lodgement. It was £220, and there were BGC bank zero credit for £70, and there was a bank charge for £20. Now, children, when you are updating the cash book, you have to update the value which has not included in the cash book. Now for an example, this BGC was in the bank statement. These bank charges were circled in the bank statement. That means those two reasons has not been recorded in the cash book. So you have to select, after you found out the reasons, you have to select the reasons which has not included in the, or whatever that you circled in the bank statement to update the cash book. And the ones which you have circled in the cash book, like unpresented and bank charges, bank lodgement, those are the ones you circled in the cash book. So the ones you circled in the bank statement comes to the updated cash book. The ones you circled in the cash book will be recorded in the bank reconciliation statement. So this method is very important and it's very easy. Now we'll see. I told you these are bank charges and the BGC are the ones we circled in the bank statement. So we are using them to update the cash book. So this cash book you have to update. This is the updated cash book. Now we took the balance 560. Now the first reason is bank charge. So already I explained, because of bank charge what happens? Our balance is more than the bank balance. So our balance, we have to decrease it. So to decrease, what you have to do? Cash book is an asset. So to decrease, you have to record in the credit side. So that's why I have credited the bank charges. It decreases the cash, so it will be recorded in the credit side. Now next one, BGC, bank transfer, directly they have debited or they have deposited, so which makes an increasement in the cash book, so increase will be recorded in the credit side. So now we recorded two reasons in the cash book which have to be updated. Now we can balance off the cash book. You'll be able to see when you balance off this side, okay, 560 and 70 gives you 630. You'll be writing on both sides. Then credit side only has a one amount, that is 20. When you subtract this, okay, 630 minus 20 gives you this new balance of the updated cash book. Okay, this is called the updated. So this here you will be saying balance carried down on the last day of the month, and it will be balance brought down for the next month, that means 1st of January. And this 610, after updating the cash book, this 610 will be used to make the bank reconciliation statement. So like earlier I said, if you started with the cash book balance, the unpresented check will be added because it makes your balance less than the bank balance. So it will be added. So you create 625 after adding the unpresented checks. Then bank lodgement, which makes your one greater than the bank statement. So what you have to do to equalize, you have to less the bank lodgement from the cash book balance. So when you less that 220, you will be able to see again after updating the cash book, when you prepare the bank reconciliation statement, you are getting the same amount which you can see in the bank statement. So children, we are making this bank's reconciliation statement to make sure, it's a temporary statement to make sure that our balance is equal to the bank statement balance. So you can use two methods. Either you can use all the reasons and make the bank reconciliation statement without updating the cash book, or you can update the cash book and using the updated amount you can make the bank reconciliation statement. So children, I hope you understood how to make a bank reconciliation statement. Do the other activities which is there in your textbook. And thank you. God bless you and stay safe.